Buzz, what are you doing?
I'm attempting to break through to the third dimension.
Yeah! Buzz, you need special glasses for that to work.
Of course! Special glasses.
Buzz?
Run!
Some see our destiny is tied to the land, as much a part of us as we are of it. Others say fate is woven together like a cloth, so that one's destiny intertwines with many others. It's the one thing we search for or fight to change. Some never find it. But there are some who are led.
I'm Maylin Lee, and ever since I turned 13, I've been doing my own thing, making my own moves, 24/7, 365. I wear what I want, say what I want, and I will not hesitate to do a spontaneous cartwheel if I feel so moved.
Sorry, legs. No nines. Go fish. She lives for this.
We'll be back after this break. Don't touch that dial, for goodness sake.
Woody and Buzz, best of pals. Who'd have believed it? None of us who lived up in Andy's room thought they'd ever get along. Especially on that day Andy got Buzz as his favorite new birthday gift. Oh, did that lead to trouble? Because up till then, Woody had always been number one. And once Sid and Scut here got in on the act, things got really bad. But I'm getting ahead of myself here.
Hey, why don't you be more careful? Hey, watch it! I am starting to get irritated!
Wait! There may be an antidote. Nothing must be overlooked. Oh! Here it is! The victim of the sleeping death can be revived only by love's first kiss. Love's first kiss. No fear of that. The dwarf will think she's dead. She'll be buried alive.
I'll bet a lot of you folks don't believe that. About a wish coming true, do you? Well, I didn't either. Of course, I'm just a cricket singing away from hearth to hearth, but let me tell you what made me change my mind.
Now, this is a story of Peter and the Wolf. As you know, in the musical score of Peter and the Wolf, each character is represented by a corresponding instrument in the orchestra.
A singing whale, what do you know? Imagine that. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. For whoever heard of an operatic whale? I don't believe it.
I don't believe it.
Time changes everything. The little spring lambs were sheep by fall. And Lambert's ma, oh, was she proud of him, because she had the biggest sheep, isn't he huge? However, he's still the butt of all their jokes and takes it on the chin. But he's not ferocious like a sheep, but he has a sheepish grin.
Hello,
And on birthday, if you have a birthday, then you... She doesn't know what an on birthday is.
Wait a minute. I'm the leader. I'll say when it's the end. It's the end.
Oh, incidentally, I'm Alan Adeo, a minstrel. Oh, that's an early day folk singer. And my job is to tell it like it is, or was, or whatever.
Sebastian, I've been looking all over for you. I've got an urgent message from the Sea King.
The Sea King?
He wants to see you right away. Something about Ariel.
He knows.
Sure. Bright young women.
Do not be fooled by his commonplace appearance. Like so many things, it is not what is outside, but what is inside that counts. This is no ordinary lamp. It once changed the course of a young man's life. A young man who liked this lamp was more than what he seemed. A diamond in the rough.
So move. Hey. That's a good move.
I can't believe it. I'm losing to a rug.
Made you look.
He's big! He's blue! He's back!
Wait a minute.
We're not getting out of here, man! We're not getting out of here! Don't you understand it, man? This is it! Game's over, man!
What's on the menu? It could be ceviche, sticky ooh, it's boomba.
I gotta tell you, Timon, that song always gets me right here.
Yeah, Pumba. Well, enough of that.
Timon, what are you doing?
I'm fast-forwarding to the part where we come in.
But you can't go out of order.
Au contraire, my porcine pal. I've got the remote.
But everyone's gonna get confused. We gotta go back to the beginning of the story.
We're not in the beginning of the story.
Yes, we were, the whole time.
Yeah, but they don't know that.
Then why don't we tell them our story?
Hey, I've got an idea. Why don't we tell them our story?
Oh, I like the sound of that.
A little backstage tour. Take them behind the scenes for a revealing and intimate look at the story within the story.
Because what they don't know is how we really were there, even though they didn't know we were there, you know?
Couldn't have said it better myself.
So, does this mean we're going back to the beginning?
Oh, no, Pumba. No. We're going way back to before the beginning.
Be prepared for sensational news.
Every time that I...
Hey, Pumba, not in front of the kids.
Oh, sorry.
My work here is done.
What the...
Oh, excuse me.
Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Get out of the way.
Who is this crowd? Hey, down in front.
Gosh.
Aloha. Okay, buddy, you win.
Sure you don't mind?
Hakuna Matata.
It's time I told you the whole story. How I lost everything and everyone I loved, and how I finally found my way back home. The truth is, I would still be trapped in that amulet today if it wasn't for a brave young princess named Sophia.
Clopin will tell you, it is a tale of a man and a monster.
Good night, everybody!
Our story actually begins long before Hercules, many eons ago.
What do you say? It's happy ending time. Everybody's got a little taste of something, but me, I got nothing. And I'm here with nothing. Anybody listening? It's like, what am I, an echo or something? Hello? Hello? Am I talking to what? Hyperspace? Hello, it's me. Nobody listens.
Deep in the heart of Africa is a place no man has ever entered. A place that belongs to the lion, the elephant, and the ape. A place known as the Bakuvu. Travelers flying overhead can only glimpse at its many marvels. Its sparkling rivers. Its lush belts. Its billowy cloud formations. And its hidden mountains. Never fear, my friends. All was not lost. Scraped and boo-booed, they searched high and low. But they never recovered their most precious cargo.
Camera back on me. Camera back on me, please. Anyone? Hello? Hello?
Could someone give me a ride home?
Do you remember the story of a girl who lived a life of cinders and how she found true love because she kept a beautiful dream in her heart? Of course, it helped that she had mouse friends who could sew and a fairy godmother who could do wonders with pumpkins. Well, that girl is me.
A healthy baby girl, a princess was born with beautiful golden hair. I'll give you a hint. That's Rapunzel.
Can be barely even friends, then somebody bends.
Oh, I'll be in my room. Get your own movie.
But when I
Hey! You get your own movie.
I was singing here.
Hey, that's not Simba.
Boat snack!
Shiny. I'm so shiny. Didn't help me though, did it? Still upside down here. Just need a little push. Can we be real? If my name was Sebastian and I had a cool Jamaican accent, you'd totally help me. You would, you know you would.
Winnie the Pooh? Wait half a darn minute. It seems to me that most of these stories are about that silly old bear.
Well then, Tigger, who should this story be about?
Well, I happen to know someone who's extremely fascinating, not to mention handsome and debonair.
But the title already says Winnie the Pooh.
Oh, that's easy to fix. Now that's a wonderful title! And speaking of wonderful things...
Hey, no cameras! Get out of here!
Okay, walks to the counter, keys.
Bloat! That's disgusting!
Tastes pretty good to me.
Ew!
Don't you people realize we are swimming in our own?
Shh, here he comes.
This is me. I think it's apparent I need to rethink my life a little bit. What's my problem? First of all, I'm a rat. Which means life is hard. And second, I have a highly developed sense of taste and smell.
Hey, everybody! It's me, Mickey Mouse. Say, you want to come inside my clubhouse? Well, all right! Let's go! Oh, I almost forgot. To make the clubhouse appear, we get to say the magic words. Miska, Muska, Mickey Mouse. Say it with me. Miska, Muska, Mickey Mouse.
Never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna run around and desert you. Never gonna make you cry. Never gonna say goodbye. Never gonna tell a lie and hurt you.
Why would I? I like you. You guys still sticking around? All right, well, you're welcome to stay. There's not really any more surprises, but, you know, good luck getting that song out of your head. It's a real earwig. Anyway, what else?
You're the best audience in the whole world. Take care of yourself.